Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to take a look at the app privacy report on the iPad. With the app privacy report, we can see how often an app is accessing our data, such as our contacts, our calendars, or our photos. Not only that, we can also see which apps they're accessing. In addition to that, we can also reverse that and look at a website and then see which apps have accessed that website and how often. Let's take a look at our app privacy report and how we read these different reports on the iPad. Now, before I get started, I am going to be showing you this on iPadOS 17, but this is not an iPadOS 17 feature. This has been around for a couple of years now. So if you haven't updated to iPadOS 17, you can still access this if you're using, I believe it came out with iPadOS 15. Either way, if you're using an iPad that's a couple years old, you still should be able to access this data. So now, where is this data? Well, let's go over to my iPad and take a look. When we go over to our Settings app, what we need to do is go over to our Privacy and Security settings here. Under Privacy and Security, what you're going to see down towards the bottom here is our App Privacy Report. Now, when I click on this, it's going to be divided into different areas. Basically, what we have here is our data and sensor access. This is how often and which data an app has accessed. So, as an example, the weather. It accessed my location 3 minutes ago. You can see that here underneath my cursor if you can see that. We can look at mail. This accessed 20 minutes ago my contacts. And when I go to show all, I can also see that photos, the Photos app, accessed my photos 5 days ago. So we can easily see which data an app is accessing. And when we go and tap on any one of these, let's go ahead and take a look at Spark. This is a mail app that I love. When I tap on this, we can see not only did it access my contacts, but it also accessed my location. And we can see when it accessed that. So when I tap on this, I can see that it accessed it on September 28. If it accessed it more than that, I would see a list of dates here. Now, this is all within the 7 days. So you're not going to see any data after 7 days or older than 7 days with any of these reports. So it's a rolling report of 7 days. So that is our data and sensor access. Our next option here is our app network activity. This is also app-centric. What I mean by that is we tap on an app here and we can see which websites that app has accessed. So in this case here, Spark, my mail program. It's accessed the internet 39 times in the last 7 days. Well, which websites has it accessed? Well, you just tap on it and you can see that it accessed iCloud and Gmail. Makes sense, it's a mail program. I have iCloud, I have Gmail in there. But we can also see that it accessed a few other websites here. And we can see when we tap on it, when it accessed it. In addition to that, we can also see what other apps have accessed that data or that website. So that is our app network activity. Again, we can see what domains an app has accessed within the 7 days. So both of those reports, our app network activity and our data and sensor access, are what I call app-centric. We look at the app and then we can see which domains and which data those apps have accessed. We can flip that around. If we swipe up here, you're going to see we have website network activity. What this will tell us is which apps have accessed these websites. So when I tap on CNN here, I can see that Safari has accessed it, and then I can also see all of the domains contacted by this website. So which websites or which domains has CNN contacted, and again, I can tap on this to see when. So now we can look at it from a website-centric perspective. When we go over to Google here, I can see that Spark and Safari both accessed Google, and then I can see which services or which domains Google has accessed using those apps. And then we have one more, which is also website-centric, most contacted domains. So which domains has my iPad contacted the most with which apps? So when I go over here to iCloud, I can see that these apps contacted that domain, gatewayicloud.com. Well, this kind of makes sense. It's Apple. Stocks, Safari, Shortcuts, News, all of these apps here have accessed gateway.icloud.com. But when we go over here to DigiCert, not sure what that one is, we can see that Spark, Weather, News, and Paste have accessed that domain. And again, this is all for the last 7 days. So you're not going to see any data over the last 7 days. So that is our app privacy report on the iPad. Basically, what we're able to do is look at this through, I would say, two different views. We can look at it from an app view and which data that those apps have accessed and which websites those apps have accessed. And then we can flip it around and look at it from a network standpoint, tap on a domain, see what our most popular domains are, and see which apps have accessed those websites or those domains. This is all located in your settings app under security and privacy. At the very bottom, you'll see app privacy report. And again, you do not need to be using iPadOS 17. I am using iPadOS 17, but this is a feature that was introduced a few years ago. So that is our app privacy report and how you can find out which apps and which domains are accessing our data on the iPad.